Hey everyone, it's Justin from Frontly again, and in today's video, I'm going to reveal the top four issues people encounter when building their app and how you can resolve these issues yourselves when you come across them. We always love hearing from you whenever any of you have any questions, but here's how you can get ahead of the game and learn a new thing or two about our platform that you otherwise wouldn't have. So let's get this video tutorial underway. So for our first example today, we have a hiring flow process here done through a Kanban block. And one of the neat things about a Kanban block by default is that you're able to click and drag any of these individual items and move them into different columns, which is great for this use case when you want to show a progression of the stages of these candidates here. A lot of times we get a lot of questions that come through asking how to disable this default ability to edit cards, just in case you want to restrict access of this ability to certain individuals on your team. And that can be very simply done through the block's edit detail view settings, where you're going to want to disable the allow editing records permission right here. Over to our preview now, you can't really see this, but I've lost the ability to click and drag any of these cards now into the new columns. I can only just click into them to see more details on the detail view. What this effectively means is that this block is no longer editable to anybody. And if I want to create a Kanban block that is a reflection of this one that is editable, I would have to create another block with some display conditions either set on the new page or within the block itself. Hope that helps. The next issue that you and your users may encounter is this white screen that never properly loads the content you're trying to access. You can refresh it as many times as you want, but it still doesn't properly load. And this could be happening on a partial level where you can still see the navigation bar, or even fully where you can't see anything at all. The way I would recommend you solving this is by looking into the configurations of a few settings here. The first place I would look is your page settings. And oftentimes when you're just beginning to build your app, for instance, you're going to be poking around, trying out different configurations and forgetting that you have set a display condition on the page. I'm going to just delete it here. And the other place I would recommend you look is on the block setting itself. If I go to the advanced settings of the block here, you can also see that I've set up a display conditioning, which could have been a blocker and having the information be shown to you and your users as well. I'm gonna get rid of that. If you and your users are still having difficulties loading the pages on your app, the last place I would recommend you look before reaching out to support is by going to your settings under general settings, looking to see if you have a default page set. This is especially the case if you have many pages in your app. You're going to want to select a default page, and hopefully by selecting one and saving it, you should be able to view your app now. Now let's go over to our preview page and give the entire page a refresh. And just like that, you can see the page now officially works after my refresh. If you continue to experience more page load issues though, please do reach out to your support team and we'll be glad to assist you from there. For our third example today, I have here a calendar block that is meant to show off some significant event dates for this disc golf tournament's calendar. You'll notice here though that right off the bat, there are no events here, but that's not how it should be. If I were to jump over to my data here, you can see that there are 10 dates that don't show up on the calendar. The remedy for this is actually quite simple. So if you look at the data here, you notice that the format is in year, month, date formatting. If I were to jump over to my settings now, into the default date format, you can see that the system has the date format set to date, month, year format. This would be the reason why your events are not showing up on the calendar, because there is a misalignment between the date input format on your Frontly app to the one in your spreadsheet. Once I get that updated on my end here and save the settings, refreshing the app here should populate those dates. And just like that, it worked like a charm. The last example I'd like to share today is to clarify some confusions we receive pretty often from our users when they're expecting to see certain changes in their edit mode take effect. I have here a hockey store inventory tracking app where I've created a custom detail view that displays more information about the product, their year-to-date sales, and a breakdown of the brand share depending on the product type that was clicked. There are a few things we'd like to call out, some of which you can see already. The stat block, for instance, is not showing the value I'm trying to pull. The info list block is only showing the first row of data regardless of whichever dynamic value or static value I input. And in addition to the dynamic values I've added as part of the label on my chart block, the hidden filters I've conditioned are not being applied. To explain why this preview appears incomplete, this is because the edit mode preview does not pull all the records or apply all the effects until the app is fully generated. This happens only when you click the preview button or when you're using your live app like any other user. To touch on the row ID input a little bit further, the displayed information will always default to the first row of your spreadsheet. So if you've included a relational data set and you're not seeing the rows line up with one another, it's likely because the data you're bringing in hasn't been generated yet, but will once you click the preview button. So yeah, just so you can see it all visually in one shot, I'm going to preview my app now. And here you can see all the record clicks pulling in the correct data. Let's start with the hockey stick. There we go. Jump into shoulder pads. So it's pulling in the correct data, it's generating the correct dynamic values, and lastly, it is also applying my filters, although you might not see it super obviously right now. So that's a wrap for this video. I hope you all learned something and have enjoyed the slight change up in the style of content today. In any case, if you run into any other challenges or issues, you can always reach out to us in support via email or chat. If you've enjoyed our videos and would like to see more, please subscribe and drop in a request into our help desk request center, where we will be uploading a new video every week based on your submissions. Link will be shown at the bottom for that. So yeah, happy building everyone, and enjoy the rest of your day.